Well, good afternoon, everybody. This is Matt Grammer here. We're going to go back to Star Trek Fleet Command and see where my ships are in collecting dilithium. So let's go there now. I'll pause this. And then when we get to the game, we will proceed. So stand by. Okay, folks, we are here. This is part two of today's episode. The first one is available on It's less than an hour long, but that's fine. Seems to be going slow. All right, let's try that again. Oh, that's much better. Oh, nice. Where are we at? Oh, we collected all. Well, some. We could do this first. 500 titanium, don't need that. All right. Oh, there we go. Runaway team is ready to return. There we go. I thought I pressed the button. Oh, good. We got Talon, Spock. So 90 Latinum, minus 977. 77 Axionic chips and 3,000 ship experience. That came up a lot. Ah, Still doesn't keep my, oh my gosh, why does it do that? Okay. When store 50? Oh, that's why. Not that I have to take it back. Just have to find new areas. Let's see. Oh, right here. Perfect. This one. Six. Oops. Okay. No. It's A. Okay, so A's got 300. That's pressing the wrong one. Oh, so that was okay. So still don't have enough. Let's see, 313, 1700, 1800. Ooh, that might work. So, okay, so how much knitting do I need? How much time is it do I really need? Oh, 50. Okay. 1500. So. 1800. Right. 1000. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So this one can be recalled. Yeah, they all can be recalled. Let's see. Okay. Let's see how much we collect. Because I really want to get to level 18. That'll be great. Okay, so 2 minutes till we return. Oh, yeah. This help alliance. Oops. Did not mean to do that. Okay. So we do have enough for Operation 19. Yes. 2 days. 2 days. Okay. Manage this one. Let's see. Swap ship. What I want to do is, oops. Oh, take you out. Take you out. Swap ship. So this is ship A. It's 10,000 strength. Go back. You should be the lowest strength. You should be the second highest. You. Oops. Should be the highest strength. Ship. There we go. We got a forge there. He is on. Mission 8 hours. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I did it right. Okay. So let us begin with Explorer Captain. All we got, so we still got data. So that brings us to 9,000. Interceptor Captain, there is. Okay. No, he's battleship. Fortok. Yes, this guy. 9,750. And battleship is Komodo. Confirm. 10,081, 10,751, 9,150. From that, 10,001, 10,031, 10,781. Health here would be that's too high. Scott. This McCoy. Director. Troy. Chen. Sue. Ah, there we go. Defense. So I need to get to 12,000 for this one. That's the most pressure. So, yes. Thank you. 14,000. Okay, so the tour ship is at 14,971. One more. Let's go back. Spock. Perfect. And I need one more in defense. Doesn't look away. Good. 14,000, 15, 15. Okay. Okay. Now, what I want to do is I need to defeat some dudes. And six. 140. Let's defeat some guys. Them in a free chest.
Oh.
All right, I've looked at Umvar. So on deck 7 of the vessel. Unfortunately, these Klingon shields are a lot more sophisticated than the ones on your station. We will need to disable the shields with our weapons. Kinda, yes. Yes, let's do it quickly too. They're coming about and already to fire. Oh, nice. Oh, let's go. Oh, heck yes, we can defeat that guy. Well, that's Stiles. That's Mr. Stiles. Let's go. Okay, let me pause this till we reach the system, and we'll be right back. All right, I got one ship in the Klingon territory. I believe we can defeat Mr. Stiles. Let's look again at the power levels. Yeah. Ship warping. Oh, that ship is warping. So this one. Let's defeat it. Let's defeat Stiles. Oh, gotcha. Stiles is maneuvered in behind the Klingon fleet. We can't take them all at once, Commander. There's a Klingon D4 closing in, charged with weapons. Oh, we can't defeat that guy. I may defeat it with this dude. That's good. Very easy. Ah, power's too low. Let's wait. Ship B is on its way. Ship C is on its way too. Just in case we need it. Go. Gotcha. Where am I? Oh, no, not you. There's no way to greet the person who just busted you out of a Klingon prison ship. Anybody else, please? Who's in charge of this vessel? This woman is nothing but a total disaster. We are staying, of course, in a nearby system to evade the Klingons. Please reserve your complaints for after the escape. That's funny. That's funny. Ooh, for our free test today, 100 officer experience. That's it. 50 deleted. Okay. All right. Oh, that's Azal. Can defeat this guy. I don't think so. This guy's still too hard. This guy. 18,000. Clan D4. Looks like we can, but that's no good. But this guy, 5,000. Let's try it. Yes, no, maybe so. Come on. Oh, shoot. Not enough. How about this guy? Still no. Okay. So that's a shawl. Oops. Sorry. Just okay. Oh, lights. Oh, that's really safe system. Oh yeah. Okay, 32 minutes, 45. Let's do 45 first. 17. Boomfire, it's good to see you. Before you say anything, it's the anomalies again. I know. You don't want to hear about the Star Trek conspiracies or anomalies anymore, but I know. Yarasa, I don't want to. Look at this message. Look, interfacing emissions, temporal signatures. It's not from around here. It was emanating from the station that this crew inhabit. Oh, would you look at that? See the source transmission. Wow, that's not from around here, not one long shot. We need to find one of the anomalies. Will that do? The one I showed you the last time I spoke? Commander Umvar and I may be able to detect where the signal comes from if you go there. Yes, much as it pains me to admit it. I think your rest is onto something. We might be able to communicate through the anomaly if this transmission is what it appears to be. The anomaly is fading rapidly. Erasa, can you assist me in triangulating the interphasic frequency? Planet. The signal is way too strong. It's going to overload the transmitter. I'll get what I can before it cuts out. It's not much. You got more of the messaging part? Where did it come from? I'm not sure. The best answer I can give you, though, that definitely came through the anomaly. It's not from our reality, I guess. I got some more raw data from the transmission, but we need my tools to decode it. It might be risky going to Iridiate so soon after breaking free, but I imagine the Klingons are too busy to hunt me down. Come on, let's see what the human message is all about. How many parts of this are there? Home, the slime pits of Iridia. What a beautiful sight to behold. Thank you for busting me out, Commander. The least I can do is give you 5% discount to go on a message. 5% discount? Are you joking? It'll be free to host on every clan in the quadrant to your front door. Well, I can't do a broker business up for free on Iridia. I lose my license, and you know what happens. When a broker loses his license, it's worse than clients, believe it or not. And give the commander the lowest price you can without any unfortunate consequences to your health. Fair? 1,000 dredge donate. K Keep your weapons down and maintain your location, Arasa. I know you're aboard that ship, skulking around like you're doing someone a favor. Come out and face me. Hey, it's Mivara. Just more luck. Sweeting, I can explain what happened on our ramp. Don't you sweeting me, Arasa. You took every last strip of Latin in my head. I want all of it back, right now, or I'll destroy you. This Iridian slug and everyone on that ship with you. Commander, I've taken the liberty to raise shields. Charge weapons, take a CL alert. I do not believe this Orion bounty under warrants for full red. You'll regret that. Shields up. Destroy. Two forwards. Gotcha. Well, I guess that's the last time I will be hearing from Mivara. Pity. Moonfire, did you get the rest of the message? I got more of the message. I believe if you take this description key I've built and find another anomaly, you should be able to get the rest of it. Russell. All right, I'll play with what you got so far. You reach Captain's Log, Stardate. Heavy subspace interference, contact Starfleet, the fourth planet to investigate. Whatever it is that the Starfleet officer is referring to, it's only a voice of one dramatic concern. I have no record of that uniform style on file or any facial recognition matches. Hey, there we go. What are we doing digging around in the transmission file? I'm in observation, Commander. The heightened energy spike, the temporal particles of fluctuation and readings. At first, I thought they were localized to your station. However, they were with us when we traveled to each location on our journey. It's not your station. Where could we be the source of the readings of the station? Be to me. But something about you or this crew, if someone somehow linked to whatever is causing these anomalies, maybe getting the rest of the message will give us another clue. A more stable temporal anomaly is situated on the edge of Rigel, setting the course. Right, so I've been there before. This is part 5. Good grief, I'm parts of it. Oh, I do, since I got more tokens, let us, oh yeah. Let's do the Federation Recruit. We do have Federation Recruit. Oh, I'm going to keep that one. Never mind. I'm sorry. Standard recruit. 100. Let's see what we get. Come on. We can update him. Val, Alvia. 300 XP. Hey, we got Val out finally. Oh, we need one more of Koth. And we can upgrade Data, we can upgrade Cadet Kirk. Awesome, awesome. Oh, we can do one more. Can we get another cough? Oh, we got Mbenga. That's nice. Cough, 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 cough. No. Almost had cough. Almost had cough. Very, very close to cough. But we do get Vela. Let's see who Vela is. Vela's overmatch. He would be science. Neo's crew, Ramanstar Empire. Vela's thirst for vengeance carried on after Nero's death at the hands of Kirk, Spock, and the Enterprise. Together with Eryx, she made her way to the Romulan, to the Romulus. Of this alternate past, and agreed to make use of the last speck of red matter in a bid to destroy Spock and the Enterprise. So Val's a lady. Can't tell that she's related, though. That's strange. Okay. Strength is 200, attack is 37, defense is 46, and health is 17. Overmatch. If the opponent's ship is an explorer, Vela increases the damage of weapons by 10%. Oh, okay. So we can put her. Oh, here we go. Now we can. Oh. Whoops. No. Ship. The weapon is an explorer. It's effectively. Oops, sorry. Strong against explorers. Oh, so I can put Vela on a battleship. Okay. Along with who? Eric's. Do I have Eric's? Well, that did. Oh, no, I don't. Okay. Eric's never lost his sense of patriotism. We found the flame of vengeance burn out of him. So Vela and Eris have to be together. Okay. Plasma backlash. Every time the opponent is hit by an energy weapon, attack Eris has 10% chance of burning it. Okay. So we need two more shards for Eris. So Eris and Vela will have to be together. All right, I'm starting up the transmitter now. Umvar's frequency is set. Engaging now. We'll get a match already. Look at him. Oh, wow, we got a match with D. That was quick. I'm decoding the message now. The audio is still corrupt, but I can relay the play the message. Captain's log started 4202.1. Exceptionally, Hyslop was interference to prevent your contacting Starfleet to inform them of the destroyed solar systems we have encountered. Science Officer Masana reports the fourth planet. Seems to be breaking up. We're going to investigate Captain James T. Kirk up. James T. Kirk? The man is, of course, older than the man we have met. Many times in recent months. Kirk, isn't that the Starfleet captain who stopped Nero? The man in that transmission must be another Kirk. If we receive this transmission, it must have been the third in the space-time continuum that links us to him, or sure. Maybe it's a warning. He mentioned planets breaking up. You know, that's a little more than I bargained for. I'm sure glad we were able to recover that log, Commander. But you must depart. You must depart? Understood. We will take you back to your ship. Let's still talk to the station. All right. Recall to the station. Nice. So we got another Kirk. 6 hours. Hey, one more thing before I go. Can you promise not to tell any Tal Shiar agents about my listening post, or any Klingons or any angry Arconians? Actually, just don't tell anyone. Your secrets are safe with us, Yavasa. I have ensured that any outgoing transmissions are filtered by the station's central computer. You should not be targeted any longer. Great. Oh, I almost forgot the last part of the recording. It was on the second file. The bandwidth was huge on that thing. I decoded it on the way back. See you around, Commander. Thank you. Commander, the last part of the message is quite short. It is. Gentlemen, I suggest beam me aboard. This probably seems to have already begun. Average blood alcohol levels in of nearby organics is, well, beyond normal levels. I'll attend to contact one of the participants. Ah, another guest. Dilated pupil, blood sugar levels dangerously low. I believe you're suffering from severe sleep deprivation. Can't sleep. Never sleep. Why not? He won't let us. God of games says the party never stops. This is extremely concerning. Commander, we should venture further and try to find this god of games. William Wrecker. Records exert a total control over his victims. They were willing to throw away their lives at his command. There I go. Four, three, one, two, 10, 629 sprints, one Taurus. Track down Mr. Ricker. Ooh, there we go. got it on file. Servers 8-2-1. Yes. Oh, hi. Hold on.
way.
Only 50. Okay. Oh, well. At least I finished one mission. Huh? Excuse me. This one. Excuse me. I can defeat. I can defeat a Klingon separatist. So there we go. 1 minute. Manage, what's my power? What power do I have right now? Oh, yeah. Definitely going back to my station. Claim. 10 minute free chest. 200 titanium. Oh no. All right, folks, we're going to defeat this Klingon separatist right now. Attack. Watch.
It's a tech.
Yes.
We did it.
We did it. Right. Oh my goodness gracious, what? Well, that does not help us. So many missions I cannot complete. I'm sad. Build a carrier. Shipyard level 20. Oh, okay. Shipyard level 20. Operations name. Oh, okay. To level 18 right now. Okay. What can I do? So many ships I cannot destroy. Okay. Playing the game. I'm playing the game for a long time.